Okay, well, I've been in Asia since, forgetting, if you count Australia as Asia since 1980, if you count not Australia since 1998, I went to Malaysia. The first analyst I had is basically the bloke I'm looking at, you.
Okay.
Because that was the first time we had an analyst. Now, that was at Mumbai City FC in the ISL, who were a forward-thinking club who did everything properly, I felt. They were an excellent club. Now, Peter Reid had analysts before in England because, I mean, the bottom line, it comes down to money.
Yeah.
You know, what budget has the club got? Now, I've got, if I have a budget and I have X dollars, do I have an analyst or can I buy a better goalkeeper or a better striker?
Yeah.
And I'll be honest, I'll go for the striker or the goalkeeper before an analyst. Not against them, but I know which one's going to keep me my job. In the short term, coaching is short term. It's not long term. It's so hard to get a long term. I've survived 3 years in a few jobs, and that's a long service league in Asia. You know, particularly 3 years is long. So it's up to a club, I think, to employ analysts because that is a position, and that analyst should be based, you know, belong to the club as opposed to belonging to the coach. They should work together, but in terms of that, so in Asia, like I didn't have an analyst in Laos national team or Thailand. Just didn't have it, couldn't afford it. That was somebody, you know, I had a physical trainer because I could afford that, but I couldn't afford an analyst. I couldn't find one in Laos, that's being perfectly honest. I had to use outsourcing things. Mumbai, they supplied one, fantastic.
Yeah.
I coached in the I-League with Mohammed Ghan.
Mohammed Ghan,
didn't have one there. That's a different story altogether though. I can talk about India later if you want. But Mumbai did everything right. And we benefited from some of the old, and especially in the ISL, where basically we were playing, traveling, wrestling. You didn't have a chance to do anything. So, coaches needed the work of the analyst.
Yeah.
And I've still got all your stuff, by the way. I keep everything.
That was my first experience in ISL. Prior to that, working with Ashley Westwood at BFC. But then, coach, the way it has changed, you know, if you see right now, I think, again, you've seen being part of ISL in different roles as well. Now, every team, if you look at the Indian market right now in ISL, every team has got an analyst, a must-have. I'm not sure if it's an AFC rule or not. And they also got an analyst for the reserve team as well and academies. That some teams have gone ahead and I've made like a 5-member analytical team, which can help on scouting, churning out data, a lot more. I mean, that's how things have evolved in India so far. But yes, not the bigger market is still trying to identify what is the value they're going to get from this.
Yeah, I think the word is value, and basically it's value for money.
Yeah.
If you've got the money, it's nice to have an analyst. If you haven't got the money, okay, and it's not an AFC rule, I'm certain. I think the only AFC rules are licenses for coaches and also, I think, physical trainers. That's fine. And I would add, I think they should have licenses for physiotherapists because I think, like at Mumbai, we had proper physiotherapists. When I went to Mohan, I didn't have a qualified physio, I had to bring one in. The quote physio, who's a lovely guy, but he had no qualifications.
Understood.
It's so important that you get recovery programs and players get back on the pitch quicker. That's so important. You know, so I think it's, you know, that is important.